Welcome back to the shop, my friends. Steve here at SKS Props, and this is part 4 in my Gears of War armor build series. In this build video, I'm going to be tackling the neck seal, the shoulder straps, and the upper back section of this armor. And I'm not going to lie to you, this section up here is going to be very difficult to put together, probably the most difficult out of the entire set, just because there's several compound curves that make it not so easy to assemble, but I have free PDF files available over on my website for all of these pieces, and if you follow right along with my build video, I will try to make it as easy as possible. I also decided to add a few basic LEDs into this armor just to give it a little something extra. I am by no means an expert when it comes to electronics. I do it good enough for cosplay, but I will try to go over the steps that I have done for these. That way, if you would like to install your own, you can. Now, all of this is made out of my HD phone, which you can find over at Blick Art Materials. And if you want to help support the channel, by all means, go through the links that are in the description section and those that are on my website and pick up some fantastic HD foam. Now, I want to show you what it takes to put the top of this armor together. Let's go ahead and get started. Up to the part of the build where I need to remove some of the straps to make room for the neck seal. I take part A and I trace and cut that out of some 10mm foam. With the neck seal sections, I spend more time rounding them over with my rotary tool so they don't look so mechanical. I'm going to glue the recessed area of part A to the outside edge of the armor on this corner. With part A in place, I can now trace and cut out part B out of some 10mm foam. This section is going to wrap around the outside of part A, and it's going to be about a quarter inch lower. Now I need to give this neck seal some rigidity, so I'm going to take the three neck spacers and glue those to the back of the armor. Now I can take part C and trace and cut that out of some 10mm foam. Notice that with this piece it's quite a bit lower. I'm trying to give all these sections a tiered look. Part D is going to be trace and cut out of some 10mm foam. This is going to act as a spacer on the corner of the neck seal. Parts E and F are going to make up the collar. Part E is going to be cut out of 10mm foam, and part F is a detail strip which will be cut out of 6. I use my rotary tool to round over all the edges and to taper the back end. These sections can now be glued to either side, leaving a gap in the middle for part G. Part G is going to be cut out of 10mm foam, but has a 2mm detail strip at the top. Once rounded over with the rotary tool, this section can be glued into place. To reinforce all these pieces, part H is going to be traced and cut out of some 4mm foam and glued to the back side. For the upper collar, part I is going to be traced and cut out of some 6mm foam. Now with all these sections, my head barely fit through, which looked great, but if you needed to, you could always decrease the thickness of these pieces to give your head more room. With the neck seal complete, I can now move on to the top of the armor, so part J is going to be traced and cut out of some 10mm foam. This piece is going to be glued around the neck seal, leaving a small gap at the back of part B. To detail the back of this section, part K is going to be traced and cut out of 2mm foam. Bob Smith super glue is added, and this piece can be lined up with the back edge. To reinforce and close this gap on the spine section, part L is going to be glued into place. Now it's time to work on the hump on the back of the armor. I'm going to take my half circle, part M, and transfer and cut that out of some 10mm foam. Part N is going to wrap around this piece and can be traced and cut out of some 6mm foam. Using super glue, part N will wrap around, giving it this half circle curve. The end of part N can be trimmed to fit your armor, but the end of this section will be glued to part J and the bottom of the half circle will be glued to part L. With that in place, part O can be traced and cut out of some 4mm foam. It's going to wrap around the outside. Just like part N, the very end of part O can be trimmed off to fit your armor. Super glue is added, and then part O can be wrapped around, creating this stack section. To detail the outside edges on part J, part P is going to be traced and cut out of some 6mm foam. These could be glued to either side, lining them up with the bottom of the piece. Now we're going to start bulking out the shoulders, but before we do that, we need to add some more foam to the under armor. Part Q is going to be cut out of some 6mm foam and is glued to the outside edge of the shoulder straps. This will give us enough surface area to attach parts R, S, and T. All of these pieces will be traced and cut out of some 10mm foam, and using my rotary tool, I'll give all these pieces a slight bevel to match the front of the armor. Once heat sealed, all these pieces can then be super glued to the under armor. This section is just a spacer cut out of 6mm foam, so just cut something that fits in your area. Part U is going to be cut out of 10mm foam and it has a slight angle in the front. This is going to be glued at the back of the strap to help support the shoulder armor. With all these sections coming together, I can now attach the inside edge of the back armor to the bottom of part J. This section is going to be the trickiest part of the build, but I promise you we'll get through it. We're going to take part V and trace and cut that out of some 6mm foam two times. The top of part V will glue to the back edge of part J. At this point, the edge of part V is going to wrap around the inside of part N. This is going to help the entire section curve along the back. The bottom edge of part V is going to be glued to the armor sections that are sticking out. For the hoses under this back section, I'm going to be using some 20mm round dowels. One end is going to be cut at a slight angle, and then strips of 2mm foam are used to detail the top and the bottom. Once these hose sections have been glued into place, additional strips of 2mm foam were glued around the middle. At this point, I cut two holes in the back of the armor to fit my hand through for this next section. Part W is going to go right inside part V. This is going to be traced and cut out of some 4mm foam. To give this piece an additional detail, I'm going to cover it with 10mm HD foam half round dowels. It was about a pack and a half of dowels for the two sections. A small block of 10mm foam was glued to the back for some additional surface area. Then this entire section can be glued down at the front of part V. For the top of this area, the sides are glued and then pressed inside part V. And here you can see I'm pushing the foam so you can see why I needed my hand to fit up inside there. This same process is repeated on the opposite side. To cover the gap and make it look like a gasket, small strips of 2mm foam are glued around the inside edge. I ended up doing two of these to bulk this section up. Additional foam was sanded down with my rotary tool. A strip of foam can be glued to the inside to cover the holes that I had cut earlier. Part X is going to be a 2mm detail at the bottom of part V. These can be traced and cut out and then glued in place on either side. Strips of 2mm foam are also glued to the back of part J to cover this seam line. So I'm to the part of the build where I'm going to be adding some basic LEDs into the shoulder straps. Now, if you're also fabricating this armor set, don't feel that you have to add lights. It is not a necessity. I'm putting these in here as a frame of reference in case you would like to try to add your own. But if for cosplay purposes, if I wasn't doing this, when it came to the painting process, instead of putting lights in, I would just paint each one of these sections blue and it would be fine, all right? So just don't feel intimidated or you can't tackle this project because of lights. Add paint in here and you're fine. Now, I'll also say the battery pack that I'm using for this is way overkill, but it's because I do a lot of commercial work. So when we have commercials or all day conventions, I do not want my batteries running out. So again, for practical purposes, what I'm using may not necessarily be the best option. There are lots of people out there that do electronics that are a lot better at it than I am. This is just one way of doing it.
So here I have a 12 volt battery pack with 12 volt LED strip lights. Before I continue, I first make sure to check the connections for everything are good. I'm going to use some styrene as a base for my LED shoulder panels. These strip LEDs can be cut at each one of these intersections. I'm going to be using three light LED sections and soldering positive positive and negative to negative. Here you can see how the panel is set up. I do a test to make sure the connections are good before attaching the leads to the panel. I assemble the second board and I attach the lead wires to that as well. The setup may not be pretty, but it works and it's good enough for cosplay. Part Y can now be traced and cut out of 4mm foam. This is going to act as a base for the shoulder straps. The LED panels are super glued to the underside, and this is so I can add more diffusing layers. I'm going to use a couple layers of high density packing foam as a diffuser. I don't know where, but this came with one of my online orders. Here you can see where the shoulder straps are going to line up with the chest armor, and these can now be glued into place using some super glue and contact cement. The two part Z pieces are going to act as spacers, and these are cut out of some 6mm foam. Notice that they're slightly shorter width-wise, but they line up perfect front to back. To go over the packing material, I'm also going to be using some acrylic that I'm going to sand one side. All of the diffusing layers for the LEDs can now be glued together, so I have two layers of the high-density packing foam and one of the acrylic. So when you get your Amazon packages, make sure to be on the lookout for good packing material. Now Marcus's lights have a slight raised edge detail, and to achieve this, I'm going to use part of this blue plastic cup. The side of the cup is cut to shape and then heated with a heat gun to flatten the surface. The ends of this are glued to small strips of foam and then wrapped around the outside of the acrylic. It's a cool way to think outside the box, by adding details to a build using random parts found around the shop. To cover the shoulders and light section, part AA is going to be traced and cut out of some 4mm foam. The inside areas of this are rounded with my rotary tool before gluing it into place. Now the main thing I'm trying to do here is line up the lights first, and then the excess foam on the side I'm gluing and tucking under part J. Now both sides of the shoulder armor can be pressed into place. And you can see how having the spacers slightly smaller underneath gives the shoulder strap a unique shape. And after pushing and pulling all this foam, I always make sure that my lights are still working. To cap the front of this shoulder strap section, part BB is going to be traced and cut out of some 4mm foam. Now don't worry about seeing all the layers in the front, we're going to take care of those by adding buckles in the next video. Part CC is going to act as a detail strip that's going to run along the bottom of the shoulder armor. These are also going to be cut out of 4mm foam and they're glued along the sides and the back. Smaller strips are custom cut for the front, and these are going to butt up to the front of Part J. There are so many details in this build, but we're getting close, and we're going to be adding the final buckles and rivets in the next build.
So you all can see the steps that I took to put together the top of this Gears of War armor set. Now I've probably only got one more video for actual assembly, and that's going to be adding all of the details. So all of the rivets, all of the buckles, all of the battle damage before I get into painting. So be sure to swing back by for that one. Now if you are building any of my builds or utilizing HD foam, be sure to tag me at SKSProps on Twitter and Instagram because I want to see your creations. Until next time, build your best with the best. HD foam.